Mark Busnich again for City Limits, and we're here today at Hostas College, where the New York State Department of Labor is holding a job fair here today. And to my left, Kim Matthews. She is an employer here, okay? She is the district vice manager.
President,
I should say. Sorry about that, Kim. With Tyson Krupp, which is the German-based elevator manufacturer, correct, Kim? Kim, welcome, welcome here. Thanks for your time. There's going to be a lot of, any minute now, there's going to be a lot of different applicants who will be walking along the floor, talking to different employers. What for you, for your company and for yourself as a hiring manager, you know, what's, when as applicants are passing by, like, what's the most important thing for you when you begin talking with them to find out what their job goals are?
Well, first I'll say what we're looking for. We're looking for somebody who's assertive, who's willing to come up to the booth, ask questions, preferably someone who's also done research in advance on our company, because most applicants get a little list of the different companies that are going to be here so they can review it. But as far as long-term success in our organization, we need somebody that's going to be willing to come in, go through our training program, hit the ground running, and then eventually relocate. We're recruiting for across the country here.
Oh, you are for today?
Yes, we are.
So, I'm just thinking of this scenario, right? Like, in, like I said, in a few minutes, people will be coming in. Now, say after an hour goes by and, like, 10 people approach you and they hand off their resume to you and you ask them a couple questions. After those 10 people, say an hour passes by, and then you kind of, you know, assess, like, what your interaction was like with those 10 people, what has to stand out? Like, what really has to stand out for you to think, to remember that person at the end of today's job fair?
Once again, someone that took the time to come up to us, not that we had to go out and search them out, that sort of assertiveness. A lot of the positions that we recruit for are sales, so you want someone with that outgoing personality. Also, somebody with a technical background, because we have a whole other group of individuals that we recruit for that become supervisors of our field force out there, the actual elevator mechanics. So an engineering background or a technological capability, that ranks very high with us.
Now, for example, somebody who like has maybe a lot of gaps in their work record, you know, what does that person need to do to kind of like present themselves so that even with that maybe that big gap that you still might consider that person for a position?
Nowadays, gaps in a work history, those are understandable. I myself left the industry for 2 years to become a mom, and then I came back to the industry. So that's not something that immediately makes us shy away from a candidate. As long as they can explain it and they have a story, a reason why, we're fine with that.
You're okay with that?
Yes.
Interesting. So for example, the people that you're looking for today, the positions you're looking for today are specifically what again?
We're looking for sales trainees, people that will go out into the field and sell elevator maintenance contracts or repairs for elevators. And then we're also looking for field supervisors, people that will manage the mechanics themselves.
Now, when the person comes here and drops off their resume to you, does that person need to be like industry specific experience, or would you consider someone who might be like, say, very committed and very open and flexible in order to consider that person?
We don't require any industry experience. That's specifically why we come to these job fairs, people that are most likely early into their careers, and we have a training program for them. The training programs are 6 months, so they learn everything that they need to know about our industry in the training program.
Well, Kim, we'd like to thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Mark Busnich again for City Limits, and now we have the honor of speaking with Victor Nguyen. He is a field HR manager for a company called GameStop, a video game supplier, distributor, or producer, Victor.
We don't produce the video games. We do distribute them, so we are one of the leading video game entertainment companies that's out there. So we have stores all over the United States, particularly here in the Bronx, and that's what brings us here today, looking for some great candidates.
So, and that's exactly what I'd like to ask you, Victor. I mean, you know, pretty soon, any minute now, you might have hundreds, maybe thousands of people
Absolutely.
Walking down this aisle. So, like, say you'll be sitting behind a desk.
Sure.
So, like, what's going to, you know, you might have, like, say, 10 people coming at you.
Sure.
They're going to come up to you and talk to you, drop off their resume, tell you what they've been doing.
Sure.
Now, after those 10 people leave and you have a little time to reflect on your interaction with them,
sure.
Like, what's most important for you? Like, what's really going to stand out in your head so that by the end of today, you'll say to yourself, I'm going to call that person?
Sure, absolutely. So there's really, from my vantage point, there's three things that I really look for. Excitement is the first thing. So if they're waiting in line, are they excited, right? Are they excited to be here? Are they excited to learn about GameStop? And hey, do they really, really want to work for us? That's the first thing. The second thing is preparation. How much did they prepare? Do they have a resume? Do they come prepared, or are they just kind of just looking just to, you know, talk and just learn about the company or what have you? And then lastly, hey, what type of skill set does this person bring to the table for GameStop? Do they love video games? Do they enjoy video games? Because if they do, then that's the person that we want.
And so if that person who you're speaking with, that they, like you said, they have to be prepared with a resume.
Sure, absolutely.
If that person asks you, does that person need to ask you for, in order for that person also to stand out,
sure,
in your mind,
mm-hmm,
does that person also need to be asking you about the company as well? Is that important to you?
Yeah, it's part of the preparation. I mean, knowing that they're coming to, you know, a career fair like this, I mean, there's a lot of companies here. I don't expect them to start asking and you know, because their role is really to get to it, see as many people as they can. So we don't want to waste their time either. So our goal is really to say, hey, if someone's just asking just basic, simple questions, what do you do? I mean, GameStop is a familiar name, so I've done a lot of these career fairs, so there's very, very few people that don't know about GameStop, so they pretty much know. So at that point, it's just really giving them information, where to go apply for, you know, positions that we have open, and just you know, move on to the next person. So,
Victor, thanks for your time.
Absolutely.
So now say you get somebody, you're talking, that person makes an impression upon you as you're talking to them, and then they hand you their resume.
Sure.
And you kind of just look at it briefly.
Sure.
And then you see that there's a gap in their employment record.
Sure.
Maybe it's like 2 years,
sure,
right?
Sure.
So then for you, like, how do you what kind of impression does that make upon you? Is that important, your overall consideration, the candidate? Or do you look at it as like, well, this person's not the only one with a gap in their employment record?
Sure. So when someone comes in with a resume like that, again, we have to go back to what we're here for in the beginning to do, and that's to see as many people as we can. When we look at a resume, and you know, I'll tell you first and foremost, this isn't really the opportunity to really comb through someone's resume. So I'm really going through, hey, you know, where do they live? Do they have work history? If they've got educational background, that's also helpful to have. But again, if they bring the excitement, if they bring the energy, if they bring the passion that we're looking for, that's an opportunity for us to invite them in for an actual sit down, you know, interview. And then at that time, I can go over their resume, and then the more intimate setting, sit down and discuss their background. So,
and Victor, so my last question is,
sure,
somebody, are you looking for specifically people who have like industry specific experience, or do you also consider anyone who might not have been in industry, but you see that they're committed, they have energy, enthusiasm, and they're very competent,
sure,
that you would give that person a chance?
Sure. Industry experience is always, you know, a positive, right? It's a positive thing. If they've got experience, great. It's not necessary. We'll teach them everything that they need to know. The only thing we need is just that passion. We need that drive, and we need that excitement. If they can come in, because at the end of the day, we are a customer service business. Our customer is number one to us, and if someone can help us service our customer and provide solution-based selling to our customers to help meet their entertainment needs, then that's all we need right then and there. It's hard to teach someone to smile. It's hard to teach someone to have personality, but everything else we can teach them.
And Victor, what positions are open in the company right now?
Absolutely. So we have management opportunities. We have store manager opportunities all throughout the five boroughs. We have assistant manager opportunities, senior game advisor opportunities, which is really a key holder position, and then regular game advisors. So.
Well, hey, Victor, listen, we want to thank you for your time today.
Absolutely. Thank you very much.